Hi everyone, Thomas here and welcome back to another video. So today I'm back here for another speed build and today we're going to go ahead and create this haunted mansion. So if you'd like to go ahead and download this for yourself, it is up in the gallery now. My origin ID is real Thomas TV1, and well, actually by the time as I'm doing this voiceover, it isn't currently up, but it will be, just because it's like a little bit earlier than I'm recording this from when this video is actually going up, so I didn't want to put it up too early because I feel like this is the main video of my kind of Halloween videos this year. I've been working on this so much, just been really perfecting it a lot, and I'm so happy how it turned out. This, you could say it's my biggest build in a way. I mean, this is on a 50 by 50 lot, but I have done a 64 by 64 lot mansion before. Actually, two of them, I think. But this one has three floors, which I haven't done a fully furnished, like, third floor before. I have done, like, dormers and stuff, but that doesn't really count. So there actually is four floors on this home because there are dormers at the top, but those aren't really functional. Anyway, so I really love how this turned out. Now, my original idea when I went in to do this was kind of to make like a castle sort of thing. As you can see, of those, what they're called, those like circle things, are they called like turrets or something? Is that what they're called? Something like that. So I put those in intending to make sort of like a castle thing, as you can see with the pointy roofs. But I do actually go ahead and keep those in, but it turns into more of just like a mansion. But regardless of that, I'm still so happy how it turned out. Now, I don't even know how many bedrooms and bathrooms it has, because like I said, I haven't uploaded it to the gallery. I normally go back and check that once I actually, you know, go to upload it. So, I'm not too sure, but it has lots of bedrooms and bathrooms. I think on the gallery, when you select how many bedrooms and bathrooms it has, I believe the maximum is 10, and I think that it's actually more than 10 of each of these things. Actually, there may be 10, more than 10 bathrooms. I think there's maybe just less than 10 bedrooms, I think. I can't really remember. Anyway, so this took me probably around, like, I would say maybe around 6 or 7 hours or something, and I spread it across a few days. And I was actually, like, originally I did start building this on Vlad's 40 by 30 lot in on that kind of like the hill area in Forgotten Hollow, but since it was a 40 by 30 lot, it was a little bit of a struggle to try and do everything that I wanted to. So I moved it to this 50 by 50 lot. Now it is in Willow Creek, which maybe not that fitting, but it was kind of the only 50 by 50 lot I could find. If you probably, like, no, I was going to say it may fit on a slightly smaller lot because of all the landscaping, but it is kind of wide as well. So maybe if you do a few adjustments, it might fit on a smaller lot. But you could, you know, it could still be fitting into Willow Creek. It could maybe come up with a storyline. Now, this is a haunted mansion. Now, I don't actually have a storyline for it, because what I thought would be nice to do is maybe ask you in the comment section about what you think of this home, and maybe if you could come up with some sort of storyline from it. So, like I said, it is in Willow Creek, so my idea behind that is maybe that it's been here for a while, and, you know, it's very, very old, and the other houses around it are being rebuilt, but this kind of marks a very important part of Willow Creek in terms of its history, so it's never really been changed that much. But on the inside, there are like a few brighter rooms, I would say, which look is slightly more modern. They do still have lots of vampire game pack items and things, but there is maybe one or two rooms which have got like brighter cream colors in them, which maybe not fit it as well. But I was maybe thinking that that room or something's been updated, maybe before it had bad history or something, and the owners wanted to change it up or something, or maybe it's been abandoned for so long, so the owners are gradually starting to update things. Not too sure. Let me know about what you think of that in the comment section down below. So right now I'm just going around with the landscaping. I didn't want to go too overkill on the landscaping in terms of, you know, piling plants on top of plants on top of plants, like what I normally do. So as you will see there, if you look by the sides of the windows and stuff, you will see a few gaps in between the plants and stuff, which is something I don't do a whole lot of, but I just kind of thought it looked nice doing that way, you know, just not going too overkill. But I do actually do a lot of plants in the garden area there, because I do put these like ponds in. There are actually swimming pools, but they are supposed to just be like ponds and stuff, and those can have lots of plants around them. Now, you will have noticed from maybe the beginning intro thing that I made that it was kind of look very smoky and stuff, and if you're wondering how I did that, I did just use those little bubble machines, I don't know what they're called, from Get Together. If you go under the swimming pool section into kind of like the decorations and stuff, it's one of those. It's kind of like a square one, and it's also a circle pattern one, which go at the bottom of the pools. So I did go ahead and put those in. Now, originally when I did this, as you can see right now, when I was doing this attempt, and I don't think I put this on camera, but I did actually go ahead and use chimneys. Now, I thought that would look really, really nice in terms of a nice little smoky effect, and that was okay, but I did kind of go too overkill on it, and it kind of just looked ridiculous. There was just smoke everywhere. But on the other side of the gate, at the very front, there are two, I believe I still kept those in, there are two chimneys. Like, if you look at the front of the gate, you may notice that there's a few plants. Underneath those plants is like a small, like a 1x1 basement. And under there, there is one, like a single chimney on each side of the gate. And I believe I kept those in. I think I did. So you will see here how the pond, well, swimming pool, looks a little bit more of an irregular shape. Because originally, the first time I did it, I made it very, like, symmetrical each side. I was kind of thinking, I don't really want it to look like that. I kind of wanted things to look a little bit more messy, so that's what I went ahead and did. And as you can see here, I'm putting lots of I don't even know what you call that stuff that I'm putting down, but kind of just made it look overgrown and like it hasn't been looked at in quite some time. I really wanted to go for like a rundown feel to it, but on the inside, it does still look very kind of posh and very expensive. Now, a lot of the rooms in this house actually are pretty, I don't know, not undecorated, but just not as heavily decorated as I would, because in normal homes, I always feel like I have to really go in lots with the decoration in it. I feel like I don't do a good build unless, like, every corner of a room is decorated, which, to be honest, when you think about it, it doesn't have to be like that. There are still some builders who don't, you know, put in a decoration in every single part of where you look at, if that makes sense. So that's what I wanted to go ahead and do today. Because I felt like if I really overpacked it with decorations, it wouldn't look that great. Because this is kind of a very old, traditional style home. Oh, my voice went high there. well, it's not that, I guess you could call it traditional, I don't know. And not really a family home either. Anyway, but yeah, so I kind of just didn't want to do that. So you will see that some rooms are maybe not as heavily decorated as others. So we're just working on this kind of hallway area. Now, I wasn't really too sure what to do with this room because it was pretty big. And so I kind of kept the decorations in here to a minimum. And also, I kind of forgot about how I was supposed to get stairs up to the third floor. But I do manage to go ahead and do that. You'll see how I do that shortly. So we're just under the kitchen now, and I did use these vampires cabinets and counters and things. I wish these cabinets had more colour swatches because the patterns on them are so, so great. I just wish I had a few more colour swatches. I probably would presume that some CC creators have done that, but like I say, I don't like to use CC in my build. So, I mean, it's alright. I only really use these counters if I'm doing like a vampire or a, you know, an older style home build, and then I'll use these. And also you can see I'm using that flooring as well from the Vampires game pack. So pretty much in this build, we do use quite a lot of Vampires game pack, which is probably the main thing you'll see. And also Vintage Glamour, because I felt like that kind of fits nicely with this pack. The main thing I used was actually the doors from it. Those two by, just the two, I can't think of the word for it. Like, because the normal, because this has got medium wall heights on all three floors. But there were some gaps which, The vampire's door that I used was 3 tiles wide, but for some of the rooms I couldn't fit that in, so I just went ahead and used a 2-tile one, and the perfect one I found was actually from the Vintage Glamour stuff pack, which kind of felt more on this style of home, fit it nicely, so I went ahead and used that. So, I believe this is actually going up on the 31st of October. I'm currently recording this on the 28th, so I hope you're all having a good Halloween if this is going up, or, yeah, I don't think I would post after Halloween. No, I think it will be going up on the 31st, but like I said, I'm not 100% sure. So, let me know what you did for Halloween, if you're doing anything fancy. Fancy. Oh my god, anyway, so, yeah, I'm not really doing anything special. Pretty sad, but, you know, I'm building this instead. So, also, another thing is, I was kind of thinking about this the other day, and I don't know if you think about this as well, but for Halloween, I don't know if this is just an American thing, but I feel like everybody dresses up in stuff that isn't scary, like doing, like, characters from movies and stuff, and I'm like, I always thought that, you know, Halloween costumes are supposed to be scary, and, like, I don't know what's the reasoning behind that, kind of just going in fancy dress and stuff. I don't know why. I've seen a few people do that. Well, I suppose it's been done for a long time, but I kind of just really thought about it recently, because when I was younger and I went out in like Halloween, like trick or treating and stuff, I would have dressed up in like really scary stuff. But I probably didn't need to dress up because I'm scary looking anyway. Oh my god. Anyway, but yeah, so it seems like people don't always dress up in really scary things, and they kind of just do, you know, random characters and stuff, which I'm probably presuming the meaning behind that, but I always thought it would be scary stuff. I don't know, it's kind of weird. Anyway, moving on. So we're just working on this kind of dining room, and I've took a pause for a second here. I'm really sorry about that. There we go. So I did actually do a dining table in the kitchen as well, but that's maybe just like a smaller for more informal events, I guess you could say. But this one's like the main formal dining room. And I went for a red theme in this, which you will see quite a bit through this house now. I know a little while ago, I used to use neutral and like those creamy colours all the time in my builds. And people kind of picked up on it, and I picked up on it myself in terms of I was using it way too much. So I went ahead and switched it up and started using more colourful colours and just different ones and just using cream all the time. So red was one of those colours that I kind of picked up on a lot. And now red is becoming the colour that I'm using more than I use cream colours and stuff, so I really need to start kind of actually, you know, thinking of some other colours to use instead of red. When it comes to doing bedrooms and stuff, I do sometimes like to switch that up. So colours in this build that you see is cream, a little bit, which, like I mentioned earlier, doesn't really fit the haunted theme as much, but it is that kind of more renovated, like, idea behind some of the rooms, if that makes sense, like I mentioned. So you see that colour, you'll see red and also some blacks and purples. I don't think there's green or anything in that, in any of the rooms. I don't think there is actually, but yeah, those are kind of the main colours. Also, as you can see there, we've got these the vintage glamour doors there. So in these kind of turrets, I think they're called, I'm just going to say they're called that, I don't think they are, but you know what I mean, those little are they called octagons? I think they are. Those little octagon rooms on the sides of the house and stuff. On the third floor, you can't actually function them. Like, that doesn't make sense. You can't actually get into them. They're not accessible, which is just, like, I wasn't planning on doing that. It kind of just turned out to be in terms of the how I built the house. But well, that's kind of my fault. But to be honest, it's not that much of a big deal. I wasn't really too bothered about it at all. Like, well, I'm not bothered at all about it, to be honest, because there are quite a few of them on the second and first floor as well that you can access. And what I did with these is actually made bathrooms out of them, most of them. So they are pretty small bathrooms. They are pretty simple as well. I actually did quite a few of the bathrooms off screen because they're literally all the same. So, because I don't know why, but in bathrooms, I never really paid that much attention to them. And I feel like that's the same with everybody. I don't know why, they just are pretty boring, I think. Anyway, so yeah, I did cut quite a few of those out. Now, when I first built this home, I was kind of thinking, because I was kind of building a castle, I kind of thought I was going to, but so my kind of thinking behind it was maybe do something that isn't symmetrical, because I'm always on builds wanting to do symmetrical things on each side. If I do it to one side, I do it to this side, and so on. But for this one, I was thinking, you know what, I don't want to have to really be that focused on it, because I felt like this is a very, very old build, and it's kind of very, I just felt like symmetry wouldn't be as much of a big deal, in terms of being a little bit more, I can't think of the word, not as very neat, because it's very old and things like that, if that makes sense. Then I said that, but then I kind of ended up doing symmetry on both sides. But there are a few things I can mention with those little octagon room things on the side, which aren't functional at the top. Now, I did have a huge, huge problem with the roofing in this build. Just because I got so many pop-outs and stuff, it just took me absolutely ages to do the roofing. Oh my god, so I cut most of it out, I think. I wasn't paying attention to the playback screen when we're doing the roofing, but I think I did cut most of it out. So I'm sorry about that if you wanted to see it, but with these type of builds, I spend so much time on them that I can't put all of it into the build video. So you will see quite a few jump cuts in this build, so I've just tried to cut out as much of the boring and repetitive parts as I could, just to make this video a little bit more interesting, because it did take me so long. Otherwise, this video would be like an hour long with everything sped up, so I did have to cut out quite a few things. So this video is around like just over 20 minutes, I'm doing this voiceover before I've edited the beginning intro thing and also put the screenshots at the end, so I'm not too sure how long it actually turned out to be, but I don't know, it's at least 20 minutes long, I can see here. So we're just working on one of those little bathrooms there. I did include that, wasn't really planning on doing it, but you know, hang on, I think somebody's home, let me just check one second. No, okay, I just thought I heard a voice, but never mind. So, yeah, we're just working on one of these bedrooms here. I believe this is on the second floor, I think it is. Yeah, it is. And this is a purple theme. Like I said, purple is one of those colours I wanted to include. I did actually do off-screen me going through doing all the floorings and wall coverings because it did take me quite long to decide it. And I was kind of thinking, what's the point of putting that in the video? Because when we go ahead to decorate that room, you're going to see what it looks like anyway. So, you know, there wasn't really much point in me putting in that. And it also saved a little bit more time in the video, which was great. So, I did put quite a few fireplaces in each of the rooms just because of the sheer size of the rooms that was able to do that. There are a few rooms which didn't, but you know, a good amount of them do have their own fireplace and seating area. So this room I was actually doing it, and I'm kind of thinking, oh, where am I going to put the bed? Because it did end up being pretty cramped. So I did just go ahead and put it in that little corner there. So I'm trying to think, oh yeah, so this video, by the time you see this, Halloween's kind of over, so we'll be really, really close to Cats and Dogs coming out. Now, like I've mentioned in previous B-Builds, I do have so many ideas to go ahead and do that, and quite a few of you have actually been requesting ideas and things, which I'm really, really happy about, so thank you everybody who's been leaving some suggestions for, Cats and Dogs builds, and just, you know, random, video ideas, which are always really helpful. So if you do have any ideas, then make sure you let me know at any time, you can do that in the comment section, but sometimes what happens is I get lots of comments and I end up kind of missing it, or I'll see it and I'll think, okay, I'll write that idea down later, and I forget. But if you email it to me, which is contact.thomastv@gmail.com, if you do it that way, I don't get as many emails as I do comments and Twitter mentions and things, so it'll be easier for me to keep track of it. And I mean, 9 times out of 10 I will go ahead and write it down straight away, but you know, like I said, there are that time that I may not write it down straight away and I end up forgetting about it. So, you know, it is a good idea to do it there so I don't lose it. So yeah, any Cats and Dogs ideas you have in terms of creative sims builds or anything, let me know, or just video ideas in general. And yeah, so what was the thing I was going to mention? Totally forgotten. It's gone. Oh yeah, I was thinking about doing a Cats and Dogs LP. Now I did actually do a little poll on this on my community tab, my channel, which I'm going to explain what that is in just a second. And I got over 100 votes at the current time of recording this voiceover, so thank you everybody who's been doing that. And I think it was like 85% of you would like to see an LP. Now, I really want you to be honest about this, because what's going to happen, and I felt like this happens with all my LPs that I do, everybody's like, yeah, do Thomas, do an LP. And then the first episode will be really popular for everybody, which, you know, is understandable. Some people might watch the first LP, might not be into it and go off it, but, you know, sometimes, not even just with the first episode, sometimes the polls are like really telling me that everybody wants an LP, but when I come to actually do it, nobody's interested. So it's not going to hurt my feelings if you be honest. I really need you to be honest with this, because what I could do is, if I'm going to, you know, spend time doing an LP, and, you know, this is going to be a little bit longer than some other well, Serena's story at least, which was only 5 parts, but, you know, it's going to be a little bit longer than that maybe, you know, maybe around the 25 to 30 part mark. So, you know, I feel like it may be really useful if you let me know, because I don't want to have to start it, and then nobody's going to be interested in it as much, and then that's taking time away from me doing builds, which all of us really love. So I feel like it would be really helpful if you could be honest. I'm not going to be annoyed at you if you say you don't want to see an LP from me, because, you know, that's just being honest and what I asked for. So yeah, just let me know what type of content you want to see. So my idea for the Cats and Dogs LP was to not actually call it a Cats and Dogs LP, because everybody and their mothers and the rest of their family is going to be doing a Cats and Dogs LP when the expansion pack comes out. So what I'm thinking about doing is maybe just doing a regular LP, which you may not see it to be focused on Cats and Dogs, and just implement Cats and Dogs in various areas throughout the LP, if that makes sense. So it's kind of like an LP with aspects of Cats and Dogs added to it, if that makes sense. Because, like I said, everybody's going to be doing a Cats and Dogs LP, so if another person like me is going to be doing it, it's not going to be that interesting and nobody's going to watch it. So I feel like it might be more interesting for all of us if I can explore some other things in the LP as well, and I think that might be a better idea. So just let me know if you have any thoughts about that. It'd be really, really helpful in the comment section or on email or anything. And also, there was somebody who voted on the poll and also left in the always leave comments. I think I'm pronouncing this right, Chanel. She leaves comments all the time in my videos, so thank you for that. And she did actually send me an email with a few ideas, and one of them being kind of like being opening like a hashtag up on the gallery and letting you submit ideas and sims and lots of things to the LP, which I think is an amazing idea. And I did actually do this with my City Living LP not too long ago. So I will probably make, if I do go ahead and decide, you know, to do a Cats and Dogs LP, because I'm not 100%... talking too fast on myself. I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to do it yet. But if I do, then I will make a video, probably like a minute long video or something, letting you know that I will have a hashtag up. At the minute, I'm not too sure what's going to be, but where you can go ahead and submit Sims and lots of things that you will see in the LP, which I think would be a really nice idea. Because I remember once in my City Living LP, my friend Tia from Teacup Simmer, she went ahead and suggested, well, she went ahead and posted a sim for me to use. And that sim actually turned into be a massive part of that LP, so you never know. So I think that might be a nice idea to do, because, you know, that sim might turn into be a massive part of the LP, you never know. So, you know, I think that might be a nice idea to do. So, probably more information about that when the time comes, but I think it's a really nice idea. So we're just working on one of the last bedrooms here before we have, I think after this we've got one more bedroom to do and then we'll be finished. So I really hope you enjoyed today's speed build. I'm really, really happy how this turned out. I spent so much time on it. Like I said, it will be up in the gallery, so make sure you head over there. My original ID is real Thomas TV 1 to go ahead and download this for yourself. If I remember, I will put a link in the description so you can go over to the online version of the gallery to check this out for yourself. And I believe with the online version, if you logged in, you can actually like bookmark it or like save it to your library. So when you go back in game, you can see those things that you looked at on the online version, which I think is a really nice idea. So you can maybe bookmark it there or something if you really want to download this, and then once you go back into your game next time, you can go ahead and do that, or just search for real Thomas TV 1 in the gallery, or hashtag Thomas TV, or hashtag real Thomas TV 1, which I put with most of my creations that I upload. And yeah, so thanks for watching. Make sure you leave, we've got like a minute left here or something, so I'm just gonna end the voice over here because we'll end up running into the screenshots. So I really hope you enjoyed. Make sure you leave a like, comment, share and subscribe if you haven't. Let me know if you have any other video ideas, because not Halloween ones, because I believe this will be the last. I think this is actually going up on Halloween, like I mentioned earlier. I'm not 100% sure, but if you have any ideas for other builds, Creator Sims, Cats and Dogs LP ideas, or you know, videos using that expansion pack, be really useful in the comment section or on email. And yeah, so thanks for watching, and make sure you leave a like, comment. I've already said that, I'm repeating myself now, I've been talking for too long, I'm losing it. Oh my god. Anyway, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.